basic data type in MATLAB is a matrix. A row vector is a matrix with one row, and a column vector is a matrix with one column. Let's see how to work with vectors in MATLAB. Let's type some vectors into the command window. We can type x equals 1, comma, 2, comma, 3. That will be a row vector. We could also have typed x equals 1 space 2 space 3. Usually that's what I do, is a row vector. If we want column vector, we would type x equals 1 semicolon 2 semicolon 3. You can have spaces if you like. And that will give us a column vector. You can access the components of x, say x of 3, whether it's a row vector or a column vector, in exactly the same way. You can also, x here is a column vector, but you can take the transpose of x using the apostrophe and get a row vector. Okay, let's clear the command window. We can generate vectors using the function zeros from MATLAB. If we want a vector with one row, we would type one row, say three columns. That would be a row vector. If we typed x equals zeros, three rows, one column, that would be a column vector. Similarly, we have ones. We could have x equals ones, make a row vector, one row, three columns, would be a vector consisting only of ones. Okay, and a useful function is the LinSpace function. That gives us equally spaced points. So let's say we want equally spaced points from 0 to 1, and let's have 6 points so we can see it nicely on the screen. That will be a row vector that has 6 values and goes from 0 to 1. So that splits it up into 0, 0.2, 0.4, and so on. Another way of doing that, we could have said x equal to 0, go up by 0.2, and end at 1. That also generates a row vector of the same type. So one of them tells you how many points, the other tells one of them you give how many points, the other you give the spacing between points. Sometimes one or the other is convenient. Let's pull back using the up arrow. We can pull back previous commands. I want to pull back my assignment to x of a row vector 1, 2, 3, and look at what happens if you multiply component by component. You have to use the dot star operator. So if we multiply x by itself component wise, we would get 1 times 1, 2 times 2, and 3 times 3, so 1, 4, and 9. That's equivalent to raising each component, squaring each component, and this dot hat gives us the same values. If we took x and we divided by x component-wise, then we would have 1 divided by 1, 2 divided by 2, and 3 divided by 3 would just give us the ones vector. Okay, MATLAB also, the functions of MATLAB can also take vectors or even matrices. Let's look at the cosine function. If we set x equal to 0, we go up by pi over 2 and end up at 2 times pi. Then we get 0 pi over 2 pi, 3 pi over 2, and 2 pi. If we look at the cosine of x, That will return a vector. Cosine 0 is 1, cosine pi over 2 is 0, cosine of pi is minus 1, and so on. These are not exact values. There is some round-off error. Many numerical solutions take the form of vectors. For example, to plot a function, you usually plot a vector of y values against a vector of x values. We'll see how to plot functions next. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.